Greetings friends, this is Sonic Toast, and we got another great unboxing today from the 2.5 inch line of Jax Pacific Sonic figures. So continuing with Wave 2, we are going to be doing the Wave 2 Sonic figure and the brand new Shadow figure. So a little reminder of what Wave 2 consists of: Sonic, Knuckles, Supersonic, Shadow, and Dr. Eggman Robotnik. So I do want to thank everybody who pointed out to me that, sure enough, Wave 2 Sonic is a different Sonic figure. It is not the exact same one as Wave 1. I'm not sure about Knuckles, but looking at the pictures, I think it is the same exact Knuckles figure. Correct me if I'm wrong. If you know, I have not found Knuckles in stores yet, so I don't know for myself, but we'll find out soon enough, I'm sure. Alright, so this is really cool. Let's see what it says about Shadow. Shadow the Hedgehog can control time and space or unleash a powerful explosion. Wow, that takes me back to Shadow the Hedgehog, the game. And Sonic, it's probably the same description we've gotten before. World's fastest blue hedgehog, Sonic runs at top speed and can use his special homing attack ability to destroy robots. Awesome. Well, since Sonic is here, we can compare him to the Wave 1 Sonic and see the differences. And of course, after that, we will appreciate the brand new Shadow figure. Toast. Okay. All right. So one thing that has impressed me about this line of figures is just how well balanced they are. They do seem to stand pretty well and pretty easily, unlike a lot of other Sonic figures. So, first things first. Wave 1 Sonic is on the left. Wave 2 Sonic is on the right. Now, these are actually very different figures. Wave 1 Sonic looks taller. It could be the angles that they are standing at, but I do think Wave 1 Sonic is standing up a bit straighter. He seems to have a more narrow body, and Wave 2 Sonic seems to have a slightly thicker body. Wave 2 Sonic seems to have thicker arms also. Let's just zoom in there. You can kind of see the difference. Just like Wave 1 Sonic, the bends in Wave 2 Sonic's arms are sculpted in. He does not have any articulation there. One very noticeable difference is the hands. As you can see, Wave 1 Sonic is pointing with a finger. Wave 2 Sonic has a closed hand. It's all kind of open. You can maybe hold accessories. Wave 1 Sonic has a fist, while Wave 2 Sonic has a thumbs up. So I guess you can put them in different poses because of their different hands. Their feet seem pretty similar, I think. Their legs? I can't tell if their legs are different at all. Honestly, Wave 2 Sonic feels like a completely different toy to me. He feels shorter, squattier. Now, Wave 2 Sonic has a very different face sculpt. As you can see, he's got one eye more squinty than the other compared to Wave 1 Sonic that has both eyes evenly open. And then Wave 2 Sonic also has this open teeth smile on his face, which I like that a lot better than the red mouth on Wave 1 Sonic, which I have complained about on Sonic and Tails and many other figures. I don't like the red mouths. So yeah, I feel like there's a lot more attitude, a lot more personality in this new Wave 2 Sonic, and I think that's really cool. I'm not saying they should go crazy and make like 100 different Sonics just with different facial expressions and different hand gestures, but still, if they are going to remake Sonic again and again, I'm glad there's a little bit of variety in there. I mean, Wave 1 Sonic was already released twice. He was released with the Green Hill Zone set and in a regular box by himself. So since they're doing Sonic again, I'm glad it's a slightly different Sonic. So there we go, cool pose. He honestly reminds me of the end of Sonic Adventure 2 when he's hanging upside down off the the Space Colony arc doing a thumbs up. That's what this figure reminds me of. All right, let's move on to Shadow the Hedgehog. Now this Shadow figure looks very ticked off. He does have some good sculpt on his chest patch. He's got some pretty good sculpting on the bottom of his shoes, though The paint job is not super detailed. We have seen worse on Shadow figures. Twiland. Anyway, so he does have gold bracelets on his feet and hands. Again, not the best paint job, but it's fine for a figure this small. Just like we were talking about with Eggman, it's not a huge thing with these teeny tiny figures. Yeah, very cool facial expression. Let's see, he's got one solid fist hand. The other one is also a fist, but it's more open. So if we had like a gun accessory, we could put it there. So it looks like he's got 5 points of articulation, just the same as Sonic. So there we go. Very cool looking figure. Not a whole ton to say. It's a small Shadow figure. Proportions wise, I think he matches up just fine with the other figures. See, he's slightly taller than Wave 2 Sonic. And he's, I think, perfectly proportioned to Wave 1 Sonic. I don't know. I always felt like Shadow was a little bit bigger than Sonic. So maybe he's not perfectly. I don't know. He's fine. His proportions seem just fine to Sonic and Tails and Knuckles. And definitely a good addition to this collection. Right, and as we compare this new figure to the 4-inch figure, also from Jack Specific, we can see he's very much a miniature version of the same figure. The 4-inch one, of course, does not have the open mouth, the angry teeth mouth, but besides that, they are pretty much the same. Different articulation, of course, but it is very much the same sculpt. Now, on the very left, we have the new 2.5-inch Shadow. You can see, I think he is the smallest Shadow figure we've ever had. Whereas on the far right is the 4-inch Jack Specific Shadow figure. And in between, we have other Shadow figures from Tomy, Jazzwares, Toy Island, and whatever the company was that made this weird light-up Shadow that I actually like a lot because he does that. Anyway, but sculpt-wise, you can see that this Shadow is quite significant. For the size, he is superior to even Jazzwares, I feel, in sculpt. And definitely to Toy Island. But yeah, definitely a cool, cool Shadow figure. And honestly, if you have not gotten on the Jack Specific Bat bandwagon yet, I suggest that you join, because I see a lot of potential in this series of figures. I mean, remember, Jazzwares is one that I and many other Sonic fans were thinking was like the best of the best, the ultimate set of Sonic figures. But Jack Specific has the opportunity to surpass them here. And even though this is a good Shadow figure, I feel like this new one just looks so much more natural. Looks like Shadow should look in the modern games, given this figure is like, what, 10 years newer? But still, it is a significant increase in sculpt and overall quality. So there we are, friends. This is most of the new line of 2.5-inch Jack Specific figures. Wave 1 and most of Wave 2 still need to find Super Sonic. And I will judge later on when I actually find Knuckles whether I'm going to get him or not. I might not if he is the exact same figure. If he is a new sculpt of Knuckles, I will probably pick him up. But yeah, once I find Super Sonic, we will do a Super Sonic video like this. And that will be all of Wave 1 and Wave 2. I happen to know who will be contained in Wave 3. So friends, this is what Wave 3 is going to look like. Firstly, there will be a re-release of Tails and Metal Sonic, right? Yeah, that's not very exciting, but oh well, you know, that's what this line is going to have, a lot of re-releases. But then there will be some new figures. I'm going to use a Tomy figure as a stand-in right now. This is a Tomy Classic Sonic, because we are getting a Classic Sonic figure in this line. I wouldn't be surprised if it were similar to this figure in size, but we will see when it comes out. And then also there's going to be Motobug. This is a Jazzwares Motobug figure, standing in for what we're going to get in Jack Specific. I'm actually hoping Jack Specific does classic Motobug and not the modern Motobug sculpt like we have here. But we will see, we will see. And then finally, the fifth figure in Wave 3 is going to be a chow, but it will not be this same chow, it will be a golden chow. You may remember where you find the golden chow egg in Sonic Adventure 1, and so that golden chow will be a new figure. I'm assuming it'll be this same chow figure, just painted gold, so it'll be a repaint. We're getting into repaint territory probably with this line of figures, something we, you know, have come to expect from Jak Specific. So yeah, that is what Wave 3 will be. So let me know in the comments what you think of Wave 3 and who you want to see in Wave 4. All right, friends, have a wonderful day and toast.